Tom, Christina, Kate, it's great to chat with you this afternoon about the exciting topics that we are hoping will be presented at PSX 2022, all of which seem to be very forward-looking and very relevant to at least the communities that I counsel. I'm particularly interested in the impacts of extended producer responsibility legislation now that we have laws in Maine and Oregon and pending legislation in New York, California, and elsewhere. I mean, if ever there were a need for education and counseling, these extended producer responsibility requirements are it. Kate, any thoughts you might have?
Yeah, and funny enough, it's along that same vein. I mean, you know, Lynn, in your role and in my job, both as a consultant and an adjunct professor, we hear lots of signals from the marketplace. And my phone has been ringing, my email has been picking up on a variety of emerging topics like you. So some of the hot ones that I'm really hearing about are circular economy, greener chemistry, how we deal with the challenges of plastics. And by giving you that list about the topics that are really emerging as new, I don't want to slight some of the tried and true topics. Plastic has been with us since the mid-70s, but there's new evolution of requirements, there's new insights, there's new conversation to be had. So I'm looking forward to PSX in Louisville, where I want to go have some of those hallway conversations, like, did you hear what so-and-so just said in that presentation? I'm going to take that back to my office with me. Whether it's on one of these new and emerging, truly emerging topics, or whether it's an emerging issue on an old topic. So that's where I'm coming from. And Christina, I'm wondering what you're hearing in your part of the world.
Yeah, no, thanks, Kate. Absolutely. Along with these topics, you know, I'm really hearing a lot about digital technologies, especially those that include artificial intelligence, data analytics, digital platforms, blockchain, social media. You know, they seem to be increasingly reshaping human actions, interactions, and decision making. So I think there's a lot to come as we move forward, you know, within this year and into 2023. And I think there's a lot of great topics that can be engaged around the demand for information, you know, whether folks are doing raw material update projects or CMS, you know, transition or digital transformations. So back to you.
Tom, what's your take on all of this? You come from a slightly different perspective, but your long history with the Product Stewardship Society and being attendant at virtually every conference, I think, ever sponsored by the PSS, what are you looking forward to?
So you're right, probably a little look back to history. This conference has evolved from a small group of people with like jobs coming together with a small program to the point now that we have a conference committee that puts together unbelievable programs every year. Product stewardship is, as we all know, broad profession. And so I've never worried about going to this conference and not being able to find some discussions from the podium or in the hallways or in the cocktail parties that were right on point as to what was going on. And I'll harken back to the first publication that the Product Stewardship Society did was realizing the business value of product stewardship. And I think you can call that a tried and true topic, but it's one that still is there today, being able to integrate the product steward work into the business. Things that were concepts, whether it be sustainability or extended producer responsibility or environmental responsible investments, those are real things now. And actually, I think in some way become easier to demonstrate the business value because our customers, I'm presuming you're in the supply chain somewhere, customers are demanding these things, and a solid product stewardship program, in fact, can help you anticipate those. So I think that's still a hot topic area, and hopefully people will be willing to share their successes or their frustrations. Those are usually in the hallway, actually. But there are their successes and how they've done that in their companies.